CBRN are threats that are very critical. They involve biological, chemical, radiological, nuclear, and even explosive menace. Now, this is very popular nowadays with the case of coronavirus. It is an epidemic that is spreading worldwide and have a significant impact. And so why we talk about that? Why we address this problem? Because nowadays, the combined use of simulation, modeling, data analytics, artificial intelligence allow us to address this problem, provide big support to decision makers. Pontus is one of our environments that has been developed to address complex urban environment, can simulate a region, can simulate a town, reproducing individual. In this case, we take a fictional representation where we can reproduce any part of the world. We take one part where we have a town and we get open data, information that we can access from the web, from the social, etc. We recreate the town and even population with all this social network. So each individual is created with his gender, age, health status, the information about his social, let me say, level, educational level, ethnic, religion, political orientation, clan, and so on. And all this population can be activated by intelligent agents. Reproducing their behavior, virtual students go to school, virtual workers go to work, people during the holiday or free time, they go and relax. We can reproduce regular behavior, but even crisis. So what it means? That we have a real framework where we can simulate the behavior of the crisis, the impact of our decision, evaluate different course of action, measure the risk, and look for best choice, and work side by side with decision maker. This is strategic engineering. A strategic engineering could make the difference to manage a crisis. In this case, we have a biological threat. In this case, we have a person that is contaminated inside the world population. As you can see, there are other persons around. This person, currently are small, tiny blue stars, are people that has been infected, but they are not yet showing the status of the disease because it is an incubation period. They move around, and along the simulation, you can see during the day, the people move around, could interact with other one because the population is spread out. If I go to identify how the population is spread. As you can see, we have people in this town, in other place, and we can evaluate what could be the best way to address this problem. Now, strategic engineering could make a difference because it's a scientific approach that is based on model constructed side by side with all the experts, expert in modeling, expert in medical and in infection. Activity, expert in operation, expert in homeland security, expert on human behavior, town administrator, all around can put their hand. It is very interactive, this is intuitive, and this allows us to give good direction to evaluate the impact, but it's not just a planning, it's to make strategy, that means to do, to plan, to do, to check, to correct. And all the information that came back from the different source, the IoT, as well as sensor network, intelligence information, reports, can be fed on the model in order to see what happened. And as you can see, evaluate what is the best way to mitigate the diffusion, for instance, this case of the epidemics, and to reduce casualty and to maximize the safety for the population.